Today I'm going to talk about the five best things about the Taft Art Museum. All right, so one of the cool things of the house was the historical decoration. So what they did in 2008 is they went through and they redecorated the way it would have been historically decorated in the 1830s to 1860s when the house was lived in. And so you see the collection that they've collected matches the decor. So it's a really cool, you can see how the art of the time fits in with the decoration of the time, which you don't usually see in a museum. So this is a very unusual feature. So one of the really cool parts of the museum is actually outside the museum, which you can see for free. You don't have to pay for it. But anyway, they put these really cool, very cool kind of thing for a small museum. You would the traditional garden, but this kind of puts it as an art installation right in the garden. Another really nice surprise to the museum is in the collection is a lot of Chinese pottery. So they obviously have a really solid 19th, 18th collection that's pretty solid, but they also have Chinese pottery, which they collected. So you don't really see that much in, it's an unexpected, and some of it you can actually, that might be a security update they need to do between the paintings. Another really nice feature of the museum is, besides some of the impressionists like Monet and others from France that were really the high point of impressionism, they have some of the impressionists from America. So you kind of see how that fits in and makes you wonder why the American impressionists weren't as famous. One of the reasons were they weren't living in the center of the art world at the time, which was Paris. And so they were living in America, and that made it less desirable at the time and less important because people were kind of prejudiced against their own art collecting. So this is kind of the America inferiority complex before the World War I, which is kind of odd to think about today of Americans having an inferiority complex. So one of the things they did in one of the recent renovations of the museum, besides redecorating, is they added a nice parking garage. So now it's, I think, 3 or 4 level parking garage. It's a medium-sized garage, not that huge. So if there's a really large cloud, it's definitely going to fill up. So you want to get in early. But for your average day at the museum, this is going to be really adequate and great free parking to go to the museum. So you don't have to look for parking, which is expensive outside, right outside the museum.